Hello guys, this is Nerdmist and today's video is going to be really special. It's related to some of my ideas which I have with respect to HMS series. All the HMS fans which have subscribed my channel, and maybe if you know some other HMS fans as well, you can definitely show this video to them and get their views on this. The video which I'm going to continue right now and the topic which I'm going to discuss, it's my opinion and it can vary from person to person, but it's just what I felt. So let's get started. So as you can see on the screen, this is a small spreadsheet actually, or you can say a small table which I have made on Word, which talks about few of the characters from Beyblade V-Force, very special characters actually, and there are few HMS Beyblades as well. So these HMS Beyblades technically don't have any sort of anime owner for them. So in this video I would like to put up my thoughts related to these Beyblades and which of these characters will be their rightful owners. Obviously, as you can see, the characters are less and the Beyblades are more, so all the Beyblades won't be assigned to a specific wielder, but few of them definitely. So let's get started with the video. The first character is this guy. His name is Danga. He owns a Beyblade named Voltic Ape, and this was his Beyblade especially in Beyblade V-Force. So he was really powerful, and in HMS series the Beyblade which he should have, which is exactly same to his Voltic Ape's design, is a Beyblade known as Magical Ape. So here, which I have marked, so I would just put it right here and just reduce the size a bit. So this is the Beyblade known as Magical Ape. So as you can see on the ends as well, they have small metal you can say points which are exactly same as Voltic Ape's attack ring. So that is why I feel Danga should have this Beyblade, if in case they make, maybe they make the anime later on. Very less possibility, but maybe. The next blader which we have here is his name is Goki, and he is from Team Psychic. So Team Psychics are basically one of the villains in Beyblade V-Force. So for him especially, like which Beyblade he can use is something, I believe something, some sort of defensive type Beyblade. So we have this Advanced series actually in HMS. Advanced series is same like if you are an MFB fan. It will be very easy for you to relate if you know about it. It is known as Maximum series in MFB. There is a series known as Maximum series which is basically like one of the characteristics of the Beyblade is heightened, such as Basalt Horogium's weight, then you have Hell Carbex, Spiral Capricorn, etc. So like that we have Advanced series in HMS. And this is one of the Beyblades of the Advanced series. It has a rubber sharp tip actually, so I believe that will be really good for Goki. So let's move on to the next one. The next blader is actually from G Revolution. His name is Miguel, and Miguel, whatever you like to say, and he is the owner of Death slash Dark Gargoyle, whichever you prefer, Hasbro or Takara Tomy. So in HMS they already have a Beyblade for Miguel. Like, it's not his Beyblade specifically, but we have a Dark Gargoyle, or you can say Death Gargoyle MS in HMS. So the only thing is that the sad part is its original release comes in a yellow color, as you can see here, this one. So there is a random booster one which comes in red, but unfortunately the original one comes in yellow color. So that is why Miguel should be definitely associated with this Beyblade. It would have been great to see him get this Beyblade at the end of G Revolution only, but yeah, it didn't happen. Moving on to the next ones, we have Jim. So this guy is one of the craziest characters in Team Psychics. He basically has Drasil, Cyber Drasil, and he completely destroys Max actually. So if we wanted to, let's say, associated a Beyblade with this guy, that would be probably Striker. That's Advanced Striker. So that would be his Beyblade. The reason behind giving them Beyblades like this from the Advanced series is this team was before they became Psychics. The Team Psychics, they were never into Beyblades which had Bit Beasts. They all were generic. It was a team which used generic Beyblades for battles and depended hugely upon their skill. And that is why this Advanced series, which you can see, they have no Bit Beast association with them. And that is why I think it would be a really good idea to have these bleeders get them. Finally, we have Selima here. So Selima, the thing is that the only two options which is left for Selima is Averazer and Eterner. So I believe it's best we give her Eterner. Advanced Eterner is so rare that a proper image like this was not available also for this Beyblade. And finally, we have Kane, who is leader of Team Psychics and leader of their previous team as well. And he should definitely be getting Advanced Averazer. His previous Beyblade design is also somewhat like this only. Finally, moving on to the last character which we have available, which is Ozuma. So this guy also has a ready-made Beyblade available. It's just not there in the anime, as his iconic fight with Zio led to destruction of Flash Leopard completely. And thereafter, I believe he should have got a new Beyblade and made his comeback in G Revolution, but he didn't. So the Beyblade is named as Dark Leopard MS. This is the Beyblade, and it's like there is no doubt also, it's completely made for Ozuma only. There is no questioning at all for this specific Beyblade. So that's it for all the associations. The only thing I would say is these two Beyblades, that is Bloody Devil MS and Shining God MS. We should have had the next series, which would have named as Season 4 HMS, where we would have got new characters, maybe a dark kind of a character who is evil, or maybe a holy character who is like a knight. So they could have got these Beyblades. And this is Aeronite, if you guys don't know Aeronite, and this is Jiraiya MS. That's Samurai Changer, that's Sea Drake or Sea Dragon MS, Phantom Fox, and Slash Raiger. So Slash Raiger, Raiger is actually owned by a blader already in the manga. So this was actually given, this information was given to me by one of my friends, Prasit, the Ultimate Raven GT. So it is basically owned by Mariah and Ray's daughter. Yes, it is difficult to digest, but yeah, Mariah and Ray have a daughter who owns Slash Raiger MS. And we also have Tyson and Hillary having a son who owns Dragoon MF. And we have Kai's son as well, who owns Dragoon Dronzer MF. So that's how all the HMS is. Actually, HMS is a very good series and should have got a separate anime as such, but sadly it didn't happen. So that's it for today, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and all the HMS fans out there, definitely share this video, like the video, and maybe all the new bladers also. You would actually get to learn a lot from these Beyblades, because these were pretty iconic compared to today's generation now. So that's it for today, guys. Take care and see you guys in the next video. Until then, take care, guys, and bye bye.